Okay, so we have to get the ID data from the platoon commander. And what I like to do here is just run straight forward and basically ignore everyone. Because as you can see, this is the guy we gotta hit. He's got the ID data in his left hand. So we can just sneak up behind this guy, go into blade mode. And you can see we get a clean shot there at the left hand. So that's a good thing to do there. And finish him off with the Zendatsu, of course. Then we can pick up the ID data.
Bravo! Excellent work! There was classified data embedded in that hand. It appears that man underwent modification at the Patriot facility, just as you did.
Okay, so the Doctor mentioned that he had Patriot data embedded in his hand, and you also might have seen a little collectible notification thing pop up saying that we were at one of, I think it was 30 in total. So we are going to be coming across guys on our travels here that have ID data in their hands. And we want to collect all of them, of course, to get all the super secret cool data and stuff. Okay, so let's just... I'm going to see if I can just avoid these guys, because I don't want to have to fight really anymore. I mean, I guess the BP would be okay. I might try to stealth kill them. They can... Whoa! Whoops, that guy kind of fell. We can get a... There we go. Yeah, sometimes they get alerted, like, right as you get them. It's a little bit sloppy, I will say that. Obviously, this game is not stealth-oriented, so, you know, some of the stealth stuff can get a little bit kind of haywire every now and then. All right, so let's see if I can... He's just walking into a wall. Okay, AI apparently isn't its strong suit either. Also cutting into this big box beside us here. Okay, so there we go. I got the Zendatsu, got the BP, so I guess it was worth it in the end. Now that we have the ID data, we can unlock the door there, and that'll let us get into the next section. Now, this is pretty much a forced battle, even though you could kind of, like, hide behind this thing. See, they just immediately see you when they walk out. This is also a new enemy type, which is probably one of my least favorite, actually, even though it ends up being somewhat common in the end. We've got these kind of, like heavy cyborgs that have been slightly more customized than these guys, and they're also equipped with a fully functioning blade that they know how to use quite well. So in this kind of situation, I like to just try to take out the smaller guys if I can. Two more just kind of randomly spawn here in the fountain. So we can take this one out. And if we can get the other one without getting hit by the samurai guy. Okay, there we go. Alright, so it should be just the heavy cyborg left. He took a little bit of damage from the blade mode stuff we did, but we're gonna have to do a little bit more work. Okay, well, he just completely annihilated me with that combo. I didn't block in time. If you can get him down on the ground, this is good, because you can just chain attacks on him, and he won't really be able to do much. Kinda like this, you can see we're doing quite a number on him. And he's in fact turned all blue at this point, so we can go into blade mode and then finish him off. You can also kind of do like a counter battle with them. You can like counter their strikes, they'll counter yours, then you counter theirs, and kind of do that back and forth like four or five times to take him out. I almost got an S on that with the time, but it's just missing that one little, like a few seconds or whatever. But there are a number of ways you can kind of take them out. Obviously, kind of like juggling them on the ground is probably the best way, but it's not too often that you can actually get them in that kind of a state. Alright, so more repair nano paste to pick up. I'm just throwing it left and right here, and we've got another VR mission here. Okay, so now we get to make our way through this building here. We're going to be climbing up some boxes. This one's in a bit of kind of a ruined state here, so it's a little tricky to make your way up. Up, didn't quite make it. You can make the jump from there. It's sometimes a little finicky, so I like to just run up the stairs. Jump across here. There's an item box at the end of this hallway here, and get a few more BP. It's always worth picking up what you can.
I have. That woman.
Raiden, what's happening? Your heart rate spike?
Yeah, I just dodged a bullet. All right, I'm heading for the refinery.
Now, I don't quite understand that reaction. Is blowing a kiss at you, like, really that devastating? Should you have put your sword up in that situation? I'm not really sure what that was all about, but oh well. Okay, so you can see if we take a look in our augmented reality mode, we've got another left-hand guy there, so we're going to have to be a little bit careful how we take him out if we want his ID chip. So one thing we can do is kind of run forward a bit on the roof to sort of get them interested. He will go into caution, and then we can just kind of round the corner and wait for them to run up. This is kind of, if you're a little bit slow like I was getting into the whole thing, then this is a pretty good way to get them up here with their backs turned. So they turn around. We can get this guy. I think this was the lefty. Actually, okay, no, it wasn't, so that's fine. So he's still got his back turned. I'm going to just drop down here and do it this way, because this is pretty much the cleanest way to get a shot at the left arm. There we go. And again, this is a very good situation for that precision cutting with the right analog stick versus the triangle button. And yeah, so it was 30 in total. He's at the bottom left. He said 2 out of 30. And this is another kind of open area where it's probably a good idea to stealth. To do this in kind of a stealth manner, because you may be able to see one gecko over there, but if you actually get an alert, another gecko will spawn, and if you have to fight two at once, like I said before, it gets a little bit hairy sometimes. So you can take this guy out up here, and there's also some items down underneath. It's like another grenade. I don't think we'd need any more of those, but that's fine. And I'll wait to get that until the coast is clear here. So it's basically just this gecko and that soldier. I like to wait till this gecko kind of walks around the circle a bit. Okay, then once he's got his back turned, we can run along the sidewall here. He pretty much have to stay up against the building, otherwise this guy in the middle of the circle, it's kind of hard to see. Otherwise, that guy will pretty much spot you instantaneously. Yep, and he spotted me anyway, so I guess we'll get to fight two geckos, but that's fine. All right, so let's go ahead and take this guy out so we don't have anyone else to worry about. Actually, it might have spawned another soldier as well. I'm not sure. Okay, yeah, you can see the two just appeared on the map. Okay, there he is. Let's take this one out then. Okay, so now it's just me and the two geckos. So we're going to have to pay a little bit of attention here. He got stuck in the ground, but you can press circle and do this little mashing triangle thing to get some good damage in. If you do this right, you can also jump immediately and then do a Zandatsu. However, as you can see, my positioning was not the greatest. So let's go ahead and just start attacking here. He also got stuck in the ground, so that works for me. Oh, and I don't have enough fuel cells to do a Zandatsu now, that's fine. Oh, okay, I dodged a little early that time. And sometimes if you hit them enough, they'll kind of like throw up there or something. I'm not quite sure what that is, but... See, this is why it gets tough when there's multiple gecko at one time, because they can attack you, especially if they're off camera, which they are a lot of the time. All right, there we go. Get another shot in here. Maybe I can Zendatsu this guy. I'd really like to get one of them down. Oh, see, he hit me as I was coming down. Okay, he's destroyed. And okay, it apparently just won't let me. That's fine. Okay, this one's gonna charge so we can finish him off here. So you can see, yeah, that one didn't quite go so well, but we still did. Oh, it isn't letting. There it goes. Oh, that was weird. And that slowing down time thing kind of screwed me over. Okay, that just kind of went everywhere, but we managed to pull it off at the end. Of course, the Zendatsu brings us all the way back. So there is kind of a good example of why multiple gecko is probably not the best thing to have happen. You can see my time was a pretty bad score there, but we pulled away with an A at the end, so I guess that works. Alright, so we got a homing missile here. It's worth picking up if you're going to come back for an optional fight here in a bit. Also, in preparation, I'm going to go ahead and slice this. Just going to create an opening for later. And this is one of the things that kind of gets on me with this game a little bit. Because as we walk through here, you can see guys just spawn in that room, even though they weren't there before. Like, I have no idea where they came from. You could argue maybe they're using stealth camo or something, but still, that's just weird. And this guy's got a left arm chip, so we want to sneak up behind him and take care of that.
More Patriot intel, bring me more! And maybe I can develop something interesting from it.
And of course, that's your incentive to get them now. This guy, you kind of have to watch which way his head turns. Once he turns to the other side, you can just walk in behind him here. And this is one of those heavy cyborgs, so it's a very good idea to get a stealth kill on him. And we've also got one more guy patrolling this hallway here, so let's take him down. Okay, and that takes care of it. And again, more braze from our comrades, so that's always good. Now we've also got quite a few items around this place because it's a pretty big open area. There's also a special one kind of over here. If we can climb up on the roof, we got a blade mode box. And this one is a large holo chip worth 5,000 BP, so that one is definitely worth picking up. I think, yeah, there's also one back over here in the corner, so, well, since we've seen it, let's just go ahead and get it real quick. And it was a grenade. Okay, so that was an EM grenade. Actually, those are going to be pretty useful later on, so I'm glad we picked up one there.
We intercepted call for backup during your last fight. The caller's position is on your Soliton radar. You can engage if you wish. It is your choice.
So at this point, we're given the opportunity to go back for an optional fight, which of course we're going to do, right? I mean, the BP is kind of nice. This fight isn't really too hard either, though. I will be using our homing missiles that we've got. So once we get here, it's up above us. We're actually going to have two hammerheads to fight. So if you have the homing missiles right out of the gate here, then you can hit one of them pretty much immediately, and that helps a lot. Alright, so I managed to get quite a lot of hits in there, because I got, I guess, like, kind of stuck on his, like, one of his missile parts, I think. I don't remember even if it was this one that I hit. I've kind of lost him now. When you're fighting two of them, it can be pretty tough. If you're trying to do this with no damage, it's almost impossible, because you're guaranteed to get shot by some machine gun fire at some point. So now we can take this one out with blade mode. And that's one down. That was pretty fast. So let's try to find a good opportunity. That was not a good opportunity. Here we go. All right, and then once you run out of homing missiles, you can try to use the RPG, he's over here. Or you can just kind of run back and forth and hit him when you get the chance. He'll kind of stay in place for quite a while. So you usually get a good opportunity to run up and get some shots in. And sitting there trying to use the RPG can be a little time-consuming. As soon as we go over there. I am actually going to, because he's so far away, I'm going to go ahead and get this one out. All right, unfortunately, I got hit while I was reloading, which makes it a little unwieldy. But, okay. For some reason, that didn't work. That's weird. There we go. And the other downside to this is that you can't Zandatsu those helicopters, so any health you're left with at the end is just what you're left with. If you saved one of the repair nanopaste to pick up, you may like want to use one here and then just go pick one up that you left, but we'll be fine at what health we have. Okay, so now we can continue forward into the next section. We get to hit one of these mysterious little buttons again. I don't really know why they have us do that. I guess it's kind of like masking a loading or something.
The cliff is just ahead at the end of the old city. Beyond that is the refinery's backyard.
So what? It's a sheer drop? The refinery's not connected to the city at all?
No. It was only built 2 years ago. There should be a narrow path around there that leads to the plant. It is protected by a fence, but probably you can cut your way through.
Probably.
Don't get cocky.
Most likely it is Desperado running security down there.
Okay, so now we again head to the indicated waypoint. Kind of a general objective, but we need to be making our way down to the refinery. Obviously, Dulceyev that we saw earlier is kind of our target, the one leading the military junta here, as Kevin so eloquently said earlier on. So hopefully we should find him here. We also might have to deal with Mistral along the way. I guess we'll have to see. So we can just cut up the fence here to make our way in. And once we do, we're going to get ambushed a little bit here by these guys. Again, if you've played Metal Gear Solid 4, you should recognize them. They can be somewhat annoying sometimes. They'll latch onto you and you have to kind of like shake the stick back and forth. However, the good news is a lot of these guys actually drop recovery units that'll recover, I think it's 25% of your health. So as you can see, we're already back up to max, which is good. Eventually, you'll start throwing some regular cyborgs into the mix. If you take them out before the little tripods here can do anything to you, then they're not really too much of a threat. If you try to fight them like both at the same time, tripod enemies work really well as annoyance enemies. As you can see, they'll just kind of leave you open for attack. And that's where they can get a little bit threatening sometimes. And especially because we don't really have anything to clear out, like, an immediate area of effect around us. We're kind of just having to rely on, you know, mashing the square button a little bit here. All right, so take that guy out. Let's get off his Zendatsu here. Okay, so that wasn't the prettiest in the world, but we will actually be getting kind of a secondary weapon later on that's going to help us out a lot with those guys, so... we're actually going to get it rather soon, in fact, right after this chapter. So again, another repair nanopaste there if you need it. Yeah, there's another item up here. I don't actually know that I've ever gone up and collected this. Let's see what it is. Probably a holo chip, yeah. Usually if it's in a kind of weird-to-reach place like that, it's probably a holo chip. Alright, so they want us to enter blade mode. I'd rather not waste the fuel cells. We'll just do some regular slashes. We may have to cut quite a bit to actually get through here.
Dulceyev and his team must be in here. Find him.
Alright, so we've got a security camera here, and thankfully it's basically blind except for that laser that it shoots out. I mean, you can get right next to it and it won't see you. So we can just do some jumping attacks here, 4 shots and they go down, pretty simple. These guys are only... these cameras are only really dangerous if you've already gotten into an alert by another soldier. Because it'll immediately kind of, alert them as well, and they'll start shooting at you. It is a gun camera, after all.
Ryder, wait. There are active IR sensors in the area. Part of factory security, no doubt, but the enemy may be using it.
So, of course, active sensors. We can use our augmented reality to see these. You can actually use Ninja Run if you're confident in it in order to just kind of make your way over these. It can feel a little weird, like you'd rather just manually jump. And also, it's worth mentioning that once you go into augmented mode to see the lasers, once you back out, they're still there afterwards, so... Okay, so once we make our way up here, we've just got one more gun camera to make our way around. So we can go ahead and destroy it in the process. And now we reach this large area. There's actually a lot of stuff to be doing around here. This is a rather large, as you can see, area with multiple levels. Got guys up on the catwalks. We've got a left-handed guy up there. A bunch of item boxes around, so we're going to be doing quite a lot of stuff in this room. First things first, we can make our way over here. And our eventual goal, actually our immediate goal, is to get up onto the catwalk. And we kind of have to wait a bit, because if we walk up the stairs too quickly, that guy will spot us on the way up. So this looks like a good time to go. We can also take out this camera along the way, so we don't have to worry about it anymore. Alright, so now we need to wait for that guy to turn around, and then we can put this column between us. This is really actually quite tricky to do stealth. Okay, wait for him to turn around again, and then we can take out this guy if we hurry. There we go. He was just turning around, but we managed to get him. And again, we want to grab his left arm. And we got it. Now also at the end of this catwalk over here is another data storage item. And that marks 6 out of 20. There's also an item box over here. But before we worry about that, I think I'm going to worry about these guards. The one in the back there that's 64 meters away. He's going to be coming around in a circle, so we're not going to be able to do anything while he's walking towards us. We're going to have to do a bit of waiting. Okay, so he's walking away now, and also that guy on the other side of the catwalks is walking away. So if we again put this column between us here, and and kind of wait this one out a bit. I'd like for him to get a little further away before we go over there and murder his friend. Done here. This infrared vision thing or whatever that we got going here is very nice. Okay, so this should be our chance. Okay, yep. Again, sometimes with the ninja run, they just randomly spot you. I don't know if it's like a noise thing or what. I'm really not sure. But there's really only these guys left, so it's not too much of a threat. Just do a couple sliding attacks and they'll go down. And we also kind of want to hide from the gun cameras for a little while. We're safe over here. None of them can actually reach us. But you can see we're still in alert because those cameras are active. So we have to kind of wait for them a little bit. Okay, so we've got the left hand. We've got the data storage that was on that side. We also want to head over here underneath to this little kind of like crate maze. I'm not really sure who like built this or why, but we've got an item box in here with yet another repair nanopaste. And as we get to the end, there's this box here. But wait, look inside there. That looks kind of suspect. What's up with this? I can't hit it.
Nice hiding spot. Wonder where he learned that from.
Yep, so that is our first man in a box. Yet another type of collectible in this game. He's begging for his life, and, well, I feel kind of sorry for them. And he's hiding in a box. I mean, to be fair, that was a good hiding spot, so we'll spare him. I guess we'll just let him live. He won't attack us or anything, so, you know, it's no big deal. You might as well just let him be. I mean, you could get another Zandatsu and some extra BP if you really wanted, but are you really that mean of a person? I mean, come on. All right, so one last thing to take care of here. We can slice open this fan and get out on this balcony. We've got another blade mode chest. If we open this, you can see we've got, looks like a huge, like, nano repair paste thing. If we open it up, this is actually an endurance plus. We actually, you can see if we look at our health now, we're at 110%. So this is a permanent health grade, a health upgrade, a lot like, you know, health containers in Zelda. It's very comparable to that. So now our maximum health is at 110%. There's going to be one of these in most chapters, so that's good. Alright, so we can open this door now and head out onto the refining tower. All right, we want to go up to get to our destination, however, let's head down first, because of course there's going to be something down here. We can activate this VR mission. Okay, so now we head back up and we are actually rapidly approaching the end of this little file here. So as we head up the stairs and up a little more, we'll eventually reach this place.
I was wondering when you'd come, Jack the Ripper.
No one calls me that anymore. Dolsaev, where is he?
I can show you a better time than that, crusty old bear.
You're in charge here?
I am Mistral. The cold wind of France. And you, your reputation precedes you. Liberian, but white as snow. A natural-born killer, even as a child.
That was a long time ago.
I was born in Algeria myself, you know? I'm only half French.
And?
We had our own civil war in the 90s. So you see? Cut from the same cloth, you and I.
You don't know me.
I lost my whole family. Everything. But I butchered those fuckers. My family's killers. That's when I realized I am a killer too. And a good one at that. I slaughtered dozens in Iraq, in Afghanistan. I'd found my calling.
Proud of that, are you?
What happened, happened. To be honest, I found it quite dull. My enemies fell like domino, one after another. Not once did I feel threatened. I was adrift, without challenge, without purpose. At times, I even envied my prey. At least they had a cause to die for. And then, I met him.
Who?
And I knew what I had been missing. His ideals gave my life meaning. Ideals, Jack. What are yours?
I protect the weak.
Still? So naive.
And if I must kill to protect them, then so be it.
It seems we have less in common than I thought.
I'll take that as a compliment.
If you would kill for your ideals, then surely you are ready to die for them.
Now we fight Mistral. So obviously, as you could probably guess, we're going to be dealing a lot with these tripods during this fight. So there's something you kind of want to keep an eye on. They're also, again, a little bit of a blessing sometimes because they can drop repair units. Oh, that one's on me. It can also make attacking somewhat strange because sometimes whenever he's surrounded by tripods, he does this kind of weird, like, kind of circle attack where he bends back. Kind of strange. Anyway, if you break her guard, you can destroy her arm staff there. I'm not really sure what to call it. And this will leave her basically defenseless. However, she can still pick up these tripods and throw them at you. So this is your chance to get some real damage in, though. All right, and then eventually once you do enough, she'll run up here. And it's a good idea to leave one of them alive, and only one, because once you kill them all, like, five more will spawn. So if you leave it with just one left at the end, then, you know, that'll actually help you out quite a bit. Okay, here we go. Alright, phase two, and this is probably my least favorite, just because we're really restricted to this two-dimensional plane here. We can only run forwards and backwards. This makes tripods pretty annoying, and also makes her somewhat annoying. You see, I'm just getting, like, I'm stuck in place because I can't get around any of these things. You also want to obviously, one's on me again. You obviously want to parry whenever she goes into the air. You also have to watch out for these attacks. If you know, again, what the rhythm of them are, you can use your defensive offense to just break through them. And you don't really get the chance to break her guard too much on this one. If you can manage to counter an attack, you can, but it's, there we go, just like that. But it can be kind of hard at times sometimes. There's a lot of action going on, so we can knock off these arms, get these tripods out of the way. I have no idea. Okay, there she is. It's like, I didn't know where she went. Yeah, like I said, she can still throw them at you. Actually managed to counterattack that and get some shots in. That was good. Nope. All right, looks like she's running towards the edge now. And you can pretty much avoid all these shots by just standing right next to her, which is kind of funny. Alright, nope. Oh, that guy actually hit me. Alright, so it shouldn't be too much longer now until we move into the... There we go. These tripods, man. I try to kind of let the music play a little bit because obviously this is where the vocal part kicks in, and that's really cool. Her song is titled "A Stranger I Remain," It's really interesting the way the boss music works in this game. You know, obviously the dynamics shifting between the instrumental and vocal versions, but also their song lyrics kind of like reflect the story of the character they represent. And this attack here is worth talking about. You basically just want to run in a circle and let her just do her thing, trying to, I don't think you can like counter it. I know you can parry the attack, but you know, if, a lot of times if you try, she'll just come up from behind. You also get some good damage in there. Watch out for the range attack, just run to the side. Alright, I'm in a very bad position here because I'm like right against the wall. But it looks like we're gonna be okay. Alright. All right, so we're doing pretty good. We've almost got her down to the end here.
Up.
I see. Time to get you out of there. We're sending a helicopter. Secure an LZ.
Understood.
And that does it for File R01. Let's see what our final rating would be. That's generally going to be how things go. The overall kind of chapter ranking in this game, it's a little bit kind of wonky to me. See, we got, you know, there's a couple S's, there's, what, 4 A's and 3 B's, but overall that averages a B? I don't know about that. I think it's a little harsh sometimes, but I don't pay too much attention to the combat ranks, really, so. It looks like we managed to defeat Mistral, however, apparently we weren't aware of Dulceyev's true plan all along. Kind of like an Abkhazia revolution type thing, because it was still kind of, you know, under the control of Russia at this point, so. Apparently took so much offense to that, he decided to just take out the entire facility and himself with it. So I don't know if we were quite successful or not, but And either way, the file is over. So let's total up our BP. We got 88,000, which should be more than enough to buy what upgrades we want. Also, as you can see, we've unlocked the pole arm. Basically, with each of these major bosses we defeat, we'll kind of unlock their signature weapon as one of our side weapons we can use. So there we go. That's going to do it for this file. So it looks like next time we will move on to file R02 and see what we're up against then. So until then, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.